Enter the Billie Holiday Vocal Competition and win $1,500. Contest open to residents of Baltimore City and County. Call 396-4575 for details.
Everything you're about to see and hear is true. Real cops, real cases compiled from actual events. Police stories told by the cops who lived them and will remember them the rest of their lives.
When I hear about an officer being killed in the line of duty, I always think about his partner. The relationship between a cop and his partner is a lot stronger than an ordinary working relationship. It's a lot stronger than an ordinary friendship. When anything happens to your partner, it's like it's happening to a member of your family. And that happens if it's good or bad. Henry and I had been partners off and on for 11 years. He was my best friend. When I got ambushed and shot, Henry was the one who got me to the hospital just in time.
Not enough water, not enough fish.
Gee, these guys never cease to amaze me.
Henry and I had just come back from a vacation together with our wives and kids. We had hit the street about 7. The morning had nothing special written all over it. A couple of family beefs, a traffic accident, fairly routine.
I don't know, Rock. They look pretty hardcore. You think you should bust them?
I was a felony arrest type guy. I wanted to go out, find some hardcore felon and, you know, hook him and book him. Henry was more studious. He had this thing for the law and its word games. He was always looking to challenge a court decision. Different approaches, but we complemented each other. About 9 o'clock, Henry saw something.
Right, hold it here. We got something here. Right in the ditch here.
He's asleep. Keys in the ignition.
He probably passed out behind the wheel. Car went up over the curb and got stuck, sat there idle until he ran out of gas.
Yeah, well, better wake him up.
Yeah. Come on. We woke the guy, got him out of the car, shook him down. To me, he seemed sober. A little twitchy, but sober. I didn't think he'd blow a 1-0. That's the standard we use for legally intoxicated. 0.10 alcohol content. I wanted to just leave him and move on to something more important. But Henry wanted to run him in for drunk driving.
It's a waste of time.
Hey, the law says if he's behind the wheel, the car's in gear, and the ignition's on, that's drunk driving.
He's not gonna blow a 1-0.
Well, let's take him in and find out.
I'll make you a deal. If he blows a 1-0, we keep him. If he doesn't, we let him go back to sleep, and you and me, we go do something else.
All right. All right, deal.
Is that a deal?
We cuffed the guy, searched him, put him in the car. I kept telling him it's probably nothing because he still seems so twitchy, and I thought, he's not a keeper. I wanted him to relax.
Hey, man, let me walk. I'll meet you at the station. Don't you worry. No problem.
That vacation must have done us the world of good. He thinks we look like rookies.
The Alcohol Investigation Bureau is where the county keeps its breathalyzer equipment. There's a 4-digit combination to unlock the door. Inside, there's a series of gun lockers. Procedure is you lock up your gun, put the key in your pocket. That's the extent of the security.
You do the test.
All right.
Ah, forgot my notes in the car. I'll be right back.
No problem.
The suspect's name was Bobby Ordonez. I found out later that he'd been on a rolling terror for the past few days. Drunk, thrown out of bars, threatened to kill a bartender. On the way back from the car, I ran into a deputy I knew. Routine warning, nothing happening, so we talked for a couple of seconds.
One shot, just that one shot. It seemed to go on forever, and I thought, oh God, he forgot to lock up his gun. I thought, I'm gonna get shot. I've been shot before. I know how it hurts, but I couldn't let that bastard shoot Henry again.
The guy was crazed. He was in a blind rage. I assumed he was on PCP. He was so powerful. It was everything I could do to hang on.
I realized that Henry was probably dead. I didn't know what else I thought. I didn't have time. My hands were getting sweaty. I could feel myself losing my grip on the cylinder. I let go and tried to get a better grip.
The Magnum fired right next to my ear. The concussion was so strong, I thought I might have been hit. The round went through the wall, across the courtyard, and into a courtroom. This alerted the bailiffs, but the Alcohol Investigation Bureau is hardly used in the morning, so the bailiffs weren't sure where I was and didn't have the combination to get in anyway. Meantime, me and this guy were still fighting it out.
Then the guy pulled the gun so hard that he pulled me to my feet. That was his big mistake. Fingers pop. I can't get the hammer to go all the way back. Finally, it came all the way back.
I hit the alarm on the wall. The deputies and bailiffs couldn't get past the four-digit code. A deputy chief of mine walked by and made a gesture. You know, just hang tough. Be back in a minute. He came back with tears in his eyes. I said, he's dead, isn't he? He said, yeah, they're both dead. I said, all right. And I just sat there. The investigation took hours. Then I saw a doctor about my ear. I ended up with 50% hearing loss. It was midnight before I got home, and I felt like there was a million pounds on me. I slept all that night and all the next day. I thought a lot about my career as a cop. I thought about me and Henry, our years together as partners. Henry and me out on the boat together only a week ago. The grand jury investigation lasted a month. I had to be at home. I wasn't myself. I wanted to go back to work. My wife didn't want me to. It wasn't a pleasant month.
I ought to talk about it.
It's here to talk about.
How can you say that? He was your best friend.
Yeah. He saved my life. But when he was in trouble, I couldn't save him.
It wasn't your fault, it was his.
What do you know about it?
Only what you told me. But I know you. You did all you could.
Look. Kids, you want to watch TV for a while? Mommy and Daddy have something they need to talk about.
Sometimes mommies and daddies talk loudly. But you've got four kids. What are they going to do if I tell them some night that someone blew a hole in your head?
When I get back to the job, I'm just gonna be fine.
I went back to work. My second night, some guy high on PCP took off all his clothes in a 7-Eleven, robbed it, and ran out of the store shooting. I drew down on him, but I was thinking, it's too soon. It's too damn soon. I can't shoot. I questioned myself about the hesitation, and I knew. I wasn't the same cop anymore. What happened with Henry changed me.
We'll be right back with ESU officer Mike Stapleton and the jumper who tried to take somebody with him.